So this is quite remarkable. I'm on St Kilda, which is the westernmost outpost of Scotland, really. And it was abandoned in the 1930s. And if you look here, we've got an entire row of abandoned houses. This was the village, the street. And number three down there has been turned into a museum. There's a couple that have been restored with the roofs on them. But this one, still empty. If we look inside, you can still see the fireplace on the end there. The roof is gone. This is number seven. Inhabited by Finlay. Finlay Gillies, who was the oldest inhabitant according to this. And there's not much here now, except for the sheep. The sheep are everywhere on this island. There they are. There's the Herta, ship we've come from. And if we look around, very quiet here, very peaceful. There's a radio mast up on top of the hill there. A few sort of cairns and the old black houses with their tough roofs. And there's a fly on my camera. And then down there at the bottom you've got the modern garages and buildings of the National Trust and Kinetic, who look after the island today. No sounds except birds and sheep and the sea. Incredibly peaceful. This building is one of the older black houses with rounded corners. It would have had a thatched roof. And if we go inside, it's very small in here. It's hard to believe people actually lived here. There's no fireplace, just dry stone wall. Well, this is interesting. It looks like the remains of a gun. I think that's been the ammunition store for it. And there, obviously. Look, there's a sheep living in behind it now. Possibly World War I, maybe even two vintage. Very much corroded. Right, we're back on the boat.